Welcome. It's June 2024, and Power BI just released their monthly update. We're going to cover all 7 helpful new features that have been released. Let's dive into it. What we're going to cover is first the visual calculation update. There's been quite a few enhancements pertaining to the new visuals you can apply this to, both the scatter plot and maps. Next, we're going to go to this visual word cloud visual. This is pretty cool. Let's check it out. Some general updates are that home desktops now updated and available across all home Power BI desktop setups. You can download large semantic models, but there's these new info functions as well. I'm going to give you an overview of those, as well as mobile tables for visually impaired people who can audibly listen to things. But the biggest update for developers in this update is going to be about how PBIR files are now available, essentially allowing super duper source control for all this stuff now. I'm going to cover this at a high level. You're going to become equipped with what's released. If you find this helpful, hit subscribe, like, leave a comment. Now let's dive into these updates. Let's go. All right, so here we are. As always, one of the first things you can do is you can go into the GitHub, the link in this video description, and download this file. The way this is going to be organized, and we're going to go through it, is we have a tab for every update. I'm going to click through. I'm going to show you what's going on. We'll look at some information, go from there. At the end of this video, you'll be completely equipped to understand everything that was released in this new update. So let's get into it. Firstly, visual calcs. If you aren't aware what visual calculations are, I will show you quickly here. But in this file and in the description of this video, I've put a visual calculation link where I've taken over a half hour to kind of go into the weeds of visual calculations. But at a high level, here's what they are. And I will add them. I will create one together. But essentially now it's available on the scatter plot and the map visual. So let's look into it. Let's say we're going to make a new scatter plot. So in this model, the model data itself right now isn't that important for this update. But I'm just going to pick net sales and we'll say product. So I will make a very straightforward scatter plot chart. Come here, pick scatter plot. Okay, cool. So we're going to change a couple of things up here. We're going to do it by net units and then unit totals, net units. All right. So let's say we wanted to actually have these go by the size, by the percentage of the total. So, or many other things, but here's what visual calculations can do. If you click a visual, you're gonna go to new calculation. Now it launches this whole new window. So two updates of this. Firstly, is that previously when you were working on a calculation field, it didn't have this green box around it. That's there now, it's small, but they wanted you to know. And if you go into this expression, what you can see now across everything, instead of having to create complex DAX, we can just click percent of grand total and then fill in these fields. So on this, I put net sales, this one net sales, and the axis, it just means, you know, if you're doing rows or columns, depending upon your table, in this case, it's rows. And look at that. Now it shows the percentage of total straight up like that. If you want to, then it's going to be over here and you can always rename it. Percent of total. And again, so it's saying Excel net units or $75,000, which is equating to 10% of the total. You can go in with formatting functions, all kinds of stuff to make this different as you see fit. But essentially that's what's available now. And again, look at this video, visual calcs. It's going to show you a deep dive on how to do it, but that will allow you to do all this stuff. Same thing with now new calculation on a map. You can do the same thing. And if you're interested in understanding more about how to use scatter plots or map visuals, I'll put these two tutorials there as well. They'll go deep in the weeds for how you can utilize all these visuals, but you can know visual calcs are available. Cool. So let's go into the word cloud. All right, here's a new visual that came out. I'm not too excited about it. I was initially excited, but I'm seeing something funky. Maybe you can show me what I'm doing wrong or educate me on this one. But what you can do is there's a new word visual. And to get it, you can go to the store, get more visuals, go ahead and search for word cloud, and boom, word cloud, there you go. Okay, so when you're here, what you can simplistically do is drag and drop a category and net sales. So in this case, I picked product and net sales, and I'm expecting to see the size correlate, which it does. But there's a couple of things I noticed first. You know, having a good word cloud visual is important, but in your tool belt. So first, this is all broken up. It doesn't make sense. So what I did notice you can do is go to word breaking, turn this off. It puts things together. Now that makes more sense. Power BI is at the top. Power BI is at the top. You know, things at the bottom, like OneDrive, it's smaller, it's down here. But here's where I noticed some funky stuff. And again, get into it yourself, leave a comment. But if I click, say, Power BI, it shows up. But I was looking for OneNote, and I'm like, where's the next one? And, you know, it doesn't show up here. Same with some other ones that just kind of sporadically don't show up. Other ones do. So I think there's something weird with this visual, but it's released. It's important for you to know. The goal of this is to educate you. Again, you can get into things like stop words. So I was looking into this where, say, I wanted to remove, let's say, the word Excel. Oop, see, it's gone. So you can turn those on and off, so it's not a stop word. You can control the way that you rotate the text. Maybe you want to get all crazy, turn all kinds of ways. Lots of options you can go there. but that's what's kind of, that's the word cloud visual. So get in there, mess with it, play with it, have fun. Thirdly, home desktop is now generally available. Here's a pic of the update itself. This is, they say it's exciting. I didn't think it was that exciting, but essentially this just means everybody now in the world generally available will see this new screen when you open up Power BI desktop. Cool. Okay, but this one was important. If you're not familiar with what large semantic models are, if you have an enterprise Power BI service, they're very important. So I put a link here so you can read more into it if you want. But essentially, a large semantic model, it will allow you to deploy a model that's larger than 10 gigabytes. It also gives you some performance improvements. But what was happening is previously, if you published a large semantic model, you could not download it back. It would just not work. They fixed that, so now you can download large semantic models, which is very helpful. Let's look at these info functions. That was a straight up update, but these info functions are neat. So released, all info functions are now available and they can take parameters. You can put optional input parameters to filter for specific queries or fields or calculations or columns. I put a link to more information about it so you can get into the weeds of it, but let's take a look. So some of the core ones, very simplistically, there's a lot of info tables, but if you ever want to see what's going on with your model, well, you can run this. So in this case, a very simple one, info evaluate tables. You know, if you want to see all the lists of them, I'll show you here. Info dot, whole bunch of stuff. So you can get into looking at all kinds of model information, as well as join them together to create a massive kind of explanation. But simplistically, if you run it, you know, you'll see here you have a table ID name, so you can join it if you want to create a model about your model. Product, sales, date, it's all pulling from everything over here. Very high level stuff with that one, but then it can get really deep. So here's every single column you have, and then you can link it back to the tables we just looked at. You can then look into every measure that you have. You can link it back to the table, and the calculation actually shows all of the DAX logic and how you're formatting and what's going on. So if you ever need to get into the info of your semantic model, it's now very easy to do so. I utilize the functions they kind of talked about in the blog, just in that description or demo, but there's a lot for you to choose from. This one helps right here, making just Power BI more accessible, this update. Essentially, if we zoom in here, when you're viewing information on a cell phone through the Power BI app, you can now do show visuals as tables in the app by clicking this button right here. We'll convert every visual into a table. This is just going to improve that accessibility level as Power BI evolves. Okay, the biggest update now is PBIR. So source controlling Power BI has not been that straightforward or easy. There's always been a semantic model storage model. There's been, you know, OneDrive kind of methods, but now they've really opened this up through this new enhanced format, PBIR. There's a link here, you can open it up. I'm gonna show you about it as well. I think there's gonna have to be a whole separate video about how to put together the idealistic source controlling process, but this is important to know it's now available. So what you need to do for this one for sure is go to your file options settings, turn it on, and I'll show you. So essentially, if you're familiar with source control, you'll have Power BI Desktop. You can save it now as this new file type. It's called a PBIP, and it makes a project file. So when you save it, you actually create multiple folders that contain multiple JSON files that you can then source control, and it contains all the backend code for your model and your report. Then you can store that into GitHub repository, check in, check out code, utilizing, you know, Visual Studio Code or whatever tools you want as well. So as an example for this one, well, I downloaded it as a PBIP and I went to the PBIR file, opened it up, and here's what it looks like in Visual Studio Code. So this is, again, now every single page in this file, there's multiple pages, it has its own key, every visual on there, and you can go through and basically, if you wanted to edit certain code, you could edit it here. But most importantly, this enables complete source controlling, because we can check this in now, you can save it back and view all the changes. So I think there will be an opportunity for a more detailed video on this, but enable PBIR, go download it. You can check it in, check it out. If you're source control familiar, this will help you. And if not, I will make a video in the future about how to have the idealistic source control set up. But that is the June update. That's all the key seven things. I hope you found this helpful. Again, if you find any value in this, subscribe, like, leave a comment. You all have a good day. See ya.